So now we have prepared the hair. Notice that there is no hair shape. And the head is tilted in such a way that the chin points towards the side of the lesion and is tilted to the right side. This tilting allows the cerebellum to fall towards the right side, since retraction is more like a little bit of a gravity. Yep, gravity helped. And there are multiple leads which we have placed. Two of them are on the eye. That is, one is for the lateral rectus, which we have slid along the lateral angle of the orbit. The two leads for the orbicularis oris and orbicularis oculi, and another one for the masseter, another one for the trapezius, and the endotracheal tube of course has got a lead for the vocal cords. That is the 10th nerve. This is the NIM 3.0 monitor in which we are getting all the leads tick marked. That's great. And one more thing I wanted to show you is that the compression boots have been applied now, and the hands have now been placed in a handrest. This is a silicone gel so that the ulnar nerve is not compressed, and there is no extension. The person is saying there is no extension of the brachial plexus. The thermal blankets have been put so that thermal loss does not occur. What else? So again, one more time, look at the position of the head. The head is tilted towards the right side, tilted in an axis in this way, tilted and rotated so that the chin is pointing towards this side, and the craniectomy site is marked here. Just part the skin and prepare. The skin is now prepared, and we are proceeding with draping. And one look at the the echo. Can you show the chambers and okay, so you will see bubbles if at all, if there is an embolism in the right atrium. Okay, fine. Okay, thank you.